Soy sauce provides a signature taste to Asian dishes. It has a rich umami flavor that can be described as savory and salty. It works well with a variety of dishes, including stir fries, dumplings and more. But what if you're out of soy sauce? Or what if you have a wheat allergy or other allergies that make it difficult to eat soy sauce? Let's look at the 12 best substitutes. So you might be watching your sodium intake and would rather not deal with the soy sauce's high sodium content. Or you have an allergy so you can't eat it at all. You might want to try one of the many soy sauce substitutes. Well, in these instances, there are many foods that make a good substitute, and I'll first quickly go through them all and cover when to use them more in a bit, so you can decide which are most suitable for your dishes. There's tamari, that's a perfect gluten-free substitute. There's Worcestershire sauce may be from the other side of the world, but you would be amazed to find how much it tastes like soy sauce. There's coconut aminos don't taste like coconut and have that great umami flavor. There's also liquid aminos, this protein concentrate is also made from soybeans. There's dried mushrooms, rehydrate dried mushrooms in water to get that signature umami taste. There's fish sauce, and fish sauce has a strong umami flavor. There's maggi seasoning. Maggi seasoning has glutamic acid that is synonymous with umami flavoring. There's umeboshi vinegar. Umeboshi's vinegar's salty taste makes it a good soy sauce substitute. There's liquefied miso paste. Now, miso paste is a great soy sauce substitute because it's made with fermented soybeans. There's salt. Now, salt may be the easiest substitute for soy sauce, and it's definitely salty. There's anchovies. Finely chopped anchovies provide a salty taste, so you won't miss the soy sauce. There's shoju sauce. Shoju is very similar to soy sauce, but it has a lighter taste. And you can always make your own. I'll cover a recipe in this video. Now, the better you understand what soy sauce is, the more you'll know what to substitute for in your dishes. Because as we saw earlier, some substitutes work better in one situation than another. Soy sauce is made from fermented soybeans, brine or salt water, roasted grains and a mold called koji. This is what makes it both salty and umami. So soy sauce is added to dishes for its saltiness and its umami. Now, tamari is a great alternative for people that love the taste of soy sauce but would rather do without the wheat. It's the perfect gluten-free soy sauce alternative. Like soy sauce, tamari is also made with soybeans, therefore it produces a similar umami taste. However, it has a richer flavor that isn't as salty. In general, tamari will taste great in almost any dish you might use soy sauce in. It's especially good for dipping and often used in sushi restaurants, even though you think it's soy sauce. Now, the Worcestershire sauce may come from a completely different part of the globe. It's British in origin, but its fermented qualities make it a terrific soy sauce substitute. It is much lower in sodium, so it's perfect for those looking to reduce salt intake. However, it is not recommended for people with shellfish or seafood allergies. The sauce is made from malt vinegar, spices, sugar, salt, onions, garlic, and anchovies, and a little bit of tamarind extract and molasses. These ingredients give it a rich umami taste, similar to soy sauce. However, it's a bit tangier and sweeter. It's perfect when used as a soy sauce substitute in meat dishes. Coconut aminos is a sauce made from fermented coconut sap. Contrary to its name, it doesn't taste like coconut at all. As compared to soy sauce, it has a similar umami taste, but it's a bit sweeter. It's also lower in sodium and gluten-free. It can be used to replace soy sauce in just about any recipe. Liquid aminos is a liquid protein concentrate, and like soy sauce, it's made from soybeans, but it's not fermented. It's gluten-free, but it contains soy and it's not low in sodium. Taste-wise, liquid aminos is very similar to soy sauce, but it's slightly sweeter and lighter. It can be used as a soy sauce substitute in most dishes. Now, dried mushrooms can also be a good soy sauce alternative. Shiitake mushrooms in particular will produce the closest taste. The mushrooms will need to be rehydrated in water to achieve a liquid texture, and in comparison to other foods mentioned on the list, they may not be as close taste-wise, but they will do in a pinch. They're also gluten-free, soy-free, and low sodium. Dried mushrooms can be used in just about any dish you would add soy sauce to, but they do not provide as rich a flavor. Fish sauce is a condiment that's made from fish or krill fermented in sauce for up to 2 years. It produces a strong umami flavor. In fact, the flavor is way stronger than soy sauce. Therefore, it's best to use it in moderation. In spite of the name, fish sauce doesn't provide a fishy flavor. It works well on meats, salads and stir fries. And I even have a complete video on anchovy sauce versus fish sauce to give you more of an idea of the taste. Now, maggi seasoning is made from a fermented wheat protein with lots of glutamic acid added. It is decidedly not gluten-free, but the acids give it a rich umami flavor. It's been called a second cousin to soy sauce. While the seasoning is effective in producing an umami flavor, it is the salty taste that will stand out. It's also extra concentrated, so use it to taste. Maggi seasoning can give any food a flavorful depth, but it is most commonly used in soups, sauces and stews. Umeboshi vinegar is made from sour plums that are salted and weighed down to produce a brine which is then sun-dried and bottled. The end product is the vinegar. The vinegar has a salty taste that makes it a great soy sauce substitute, but it doesn't have as much of a rich umami flavor. Some recommend combining it with aminos to get the best of both worlds. Although umeboshi tastes good on most foods, it's recommended for its ability to add taste to cooked vegetables. It can also enhance the taste of salad dressings. A miso paste is very similar to soy sauce, and like soy sauce, it's also made from fermented soybeans and it is also inoculated with koji. Therefore, it should come as no surprise that it makes a good substitute in recipes. The biggest challenge in using miso paste will be converting it into a liquid substance. This can be achieved with the addition of water, vinegar and aminos. The type of paste you use will affect the flavor profile. So red miso is deep and flavorful, making it an ideal soy sauce substitute as compared to milder varieties like yellow or white miso. Because miso is so similar to soy sauce, it will make an ideal alternative in any meal. Then there's salt. Well, sure, salt doesn't have the umami taste soy sauce does, but it definitely brings saltiness. The best part is almost everyone has salt in their kitchen cabinets, so it makes it easier to substitute if nothing else. Sea salt is another option. Sea salt differs from regular salt in both texture and processing. Some say the two have slightly different tastes, while others say it's barely detectable. All the same, if you prefer one to the other, use your preference as your soy sauce alternative. Now, anchovies have a salty rich flavor that can be compared to soy sauce. When finely chopped, they can be added to a stir fry or a sauce to achieve a similar taste. However, because anchovies can't be made into a liquid, they will not work well as a dipping sauce or marinade unless they are mixed in with the sauce beforehand and blended. Anchovies can also be overbearing when used in recipes, so go easy when adding them to your dishes. Then there's shoju. It's the name for Japanese style soy sauce. There are light and dark shoju varieties, and it's made from similar ingredients including soybeans, wheat, salt and water. Shoju tends to be thinner and lighter than other types of soy sauce, but essentially there are very few differences between shoju and soy sauce. Therefore, it makes an ideal substitute for any dish. And you can always make your own soy sauce substitute. If you have a soy allergy or can't eat wheat, then there's this great recipe that you can make. You need 4 tablespoons of beef bouillon, 2 teaspoons of dark molasses, 4 teaspoons of balsamic vinegar, 1 pinch of white pepper, 1/2 teaspoon of ground ginger, 1.5 cups of water, 1 pinch of garlic powder. Now mix all the ingredients together in a saucepan, stir them together over medium heat and let the mixture come to a boil. Let it boil until it's reduced to 1 cup. This should be achieved in about 15 minutes. This recipe will yield 1 cup or 8 ounces of soy sauce, and the smaller bottles you buy at the grocery store are typically 5 ounces or so, so this will give you plenty to use in your recipes and for your condiment needs. In terms of cost, the entire recipe will cost you about 90 cents, which is a lot cheaper than any bottle of decent soy sauce you can buy in the market. Now, most of those ingredients you'll probably have, but if you're thinking, hey, I was looking for a substitute for soy sauce because I don't have any at hand, but I don't have molasses at hand either. You know, it's the best substitute though because it has the right color as well. But you can also use 2 teaspoons of corn syrup, the dark kind if you have it, honey or maple syrup instead of molasses. You might not get the same thickness of the makeshift soy sauce or the right color, but you'll be on the right track for the perfect fit in your dish. Now, I hope this video helped you. Also check out my video on anchovy sauce versus fish sauce or this complete playlist on getting the right Japanese umami.